this series of short movies, I wanted to show you, to remind you some basic stuff that you need to know for mathematics recent exam. Okay, so let's start with matrix multiplication. How do we multiply two matrices? First, we look at the dimension of matrices. This one has three rows and two columns. This one has two rows and two columns. Can we multiply them? Yes. Why? Because second number here and first number here, so number of columns in the first matrix and number of rows in the second matrix are the same. Now, what will be the dimension of matrix that's going to be a product of these two? Well, 3 by 2. We always take those dimensions at the very end. Okay, and look, the basic idea of multiplying a matrix is to multiply each row by each column. So each row from the first matrix by each column of the second matrix. Look, first we look for element that's gonna lie in row one, in first row, first column. So we multiply first row, first column. 1 times 1 is 1, plus 4 times 3 is 12. Then, this element, second row, first column. So, 3 times 1 is 3, plus 0 times 3, 0. Then we have 2 times 1, 2, plus 1 times 3, 3. Okay, and then we need to calculate elements in a second column, so we're gonna be using the second column. 1 times 1 is 1, plus 4 times 0, 0. 3 times 1 is 3, 0 times 0 is 0. 2 times 3 is 6, 1 times 0 is 0. So, if the answer is 13, 3, 6, 1, 3, 6. And this is it. This is how we multiply two matrices. The second thing I wanted to review with you is Cramers. Okay, so look, here we have a system of two simultaneous equations with two unknowns. First thing we do, we put it into matrix notation. So we've got coefficients, 2, 1, 1, 2, right? Now, variables and constant terms. So, first thing we do is we calculate the determinant, and this is 2 times 2, which is 4, minus 1 times 1, which is 1, this is 3. Because this is different than 0, we know that we can find solutions. Okay, so what do we do next? Now, if we want to find x, we first calculate ax. We take this vector and we put it in place of the first and we get that this is 3, 6, 1, 2. And look, there are different ways in which you can calculate this. Of course, you can just calculate it numerically. It's 6 minus 6, it's 0. The nice way would be, for example, to take 3 out of the first column. We already see that those two, and we can take 2 out of them. Last row, and we clearly see that this is 1 minus 1, which is 0. But remember, you can simply calculate it as 6 minus 6. And now, x is equal to ax determinant A 0 divided by 3, it is 0. Okay, then we do the same thing for the second variable. So we've got A Y equals 2. 2, 1. Now we replace the second column. Okay, and look, again we can take something out of the determinant, out of the second column we can take 3. We got 2, 1, 1, 2. And we see that it's the same as determinant. So this is 3 times. Negative 1, so we got this is 9, and we obtain that y is equal to ay over a, and this is equal to 9 over 3, which is 3. And look, 0 plus 3 is 3, 0 plus 6 is 6. Makes sense. Okay, in the next movie, we will calculate some derivatives.